name is Jerzy Wczewski, and I live in New York, and I'm visiting the embassy, Polish embassy in Washington. By accident, I found myself in the Middle East, being a refugee from 1939 through Romania, Turkey. I finished my school in a Polish school in Tel Aviv and joined the Carpathian Brigade and then the Libyan Front. And then there was a campaign of finding volunteers for three services of Polish armed forces in England: Air Force, Navy, and paratroopers. And there was a choice, one of these three, to make quickly in 1 hour. And so I chose Air Force. I had some connections with the tradition of Polish Air Force before the war as a teenager. But that's how I signed up, and then I was transported through all kind of adventures to England finally in the summer of 1942, where I started my training. Ended up, there were several steps, of course, in this training process. It was all run by the Polish experienced airmen, and I became a fighter pilot, and I was posted just before the D-Day, as it happened, to the 308 Polish Squadron, which was one of the three squadrons in a wing. Three squadrons were making a wing, and that wing was established in France already, after the invasion. And then I was there in Europe, France, Belgium, Holland, until we were one of the first units of the Allied Air Force stationed in Germany. And that was the end of the war. Since I came back to Poland after the war, you know, there was nothing to brag about that I was in the West. Basically, this was something officially nobody talked about. So I was an architect, I finished architecture. I had to work up to here of rebuilding, first of all, Warsaw and the historic monuments. That's where I was involved in this very much. So the wartime histories were somewhere in the background. In the Museum of Royal Air Force, where they got very much interested about the role the Polish Air Force played, as if nobody knew about it. Of course, it was very little known generally, because during the post-war years, the Polish government was not very eager to publicize the role of Polish Air Force in the West, because of political reasons and restrictions. So then I spent some time at the museum making interviews. I brought my books, my albums of photographs, which I have a large collection of my story. It was a quite unexpected invitation to be honored during the yearly big gala in Washington, D.C., organized in the Willard Hotel Ballroom by the so-called American Foundation of the Battle of Britain. I was a keynote speaker. A representative of the Polish embassy was there also. And we were sitting at the head table. On my right was Chief Marshal of the Royal Air Force. And then I was invited to make my speech. And before that, there were toasts, traditional Royal Air Force tradition of drinking toast with port wine. And there was a toast for the Queen Elizabeth and the Royal and the British anthem, national anthem, God Save the Queen. Then there was a toast to President Barack Obama and the American anthem. And there was a toast to President Komorowski and the Polish national anthem. And then I was asked to speak. And I must tell you, I just stood there on this podium and I had tears in my eyes because this was quite unexpected honor to have all this toast just before, like an introduction to my 15-minute talk about my experience, which is a shortcut, which I am doing now.